Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Eckyman, and welcome back to another episode of our playthrough of the forest. Okay, so nothing is there. I've been kind of busy. I can't remember what I had now in the last episode. Let me eat one of these. I've built these rock holders. I've been collecting rocks. I've been collecting sticks, and I also have a load of logs ready to go. So first thing we're going to do today is hopefully finish work on this. And there we go, got some more here. And there we go, it's done. So if I climb up here, oh yeah, I need to get some water. I'll go do that in a second. Yeah, so if we come up here, we can now access this area quite safely. And yeah, what do we need? We need sticks. Lots and lots of sticks and rocks. So we're going to finish work on this right now. It's good. I've got some logs left over for other things. I want to put a defensive wall up. That's all I can get of those. Been attacked a few times. I have some bones collected here, ready to go for some more armor. Do I have some? I've got some spare armor on me as well. Oh. There we go. I've also been over to the camp, got myself some other supplies as well. So we're good to go for a bit. Hopefully, we won't get attacked. Drink some filthy pond water, because that seems like a great idea. Okay. Well, let's. Who needs rocks? Who needs rocks? Anyone need rocks? You do. You do. Okay. Get some more rocks and sticks. Yeah, so we're going to build a defensive wall around this place and hopefully make it a bit safer. I want to build my base up on some platforms. And then I'm going to connect everything up with these towers. Oops. Yeah, I'm going to connect everything up with these towers so that we rarely, if ever, have to come down onto the ground. I think that's the strategy we're going to use. Someone did give me a good tip on maybe the first or the second episode. I'm quite a few episodes ahead. But apparently, if we turn color grading to M131 during the night or in caves, that makes it much easier to see. So we may actually work through the night a little bit. Yeah, let's not get caught in our own trap here. There we go. I want to get the defensive wall up soon, but I think before we do that, I need to start placing down some blueprints for the base. So we're probably going to work on that soon. And I have this outside of my base, this tower. Or do I want? No, we'll have the tower outside of my base. Don't walk over that. Wow, this needs so many sticks to do. It's going to be worth it, though. I think. I hope. So, yeah, as I've been doing stuff, I've basically just been picking up sticks and rocks as I go, bringing them back over here, over to the base, and dumping them in those holders. So there's another one. Am I gonna run out of twigs before this is ready to go? Sorry about keyboard noise there. I probably am, but that's fine. We've got loads around here that we can use. Surprised we haven't been attacked yet. Right, so I wanted to do something. I have increased the quality of my recordings because I noticed... Alright, so basically, the last run of Forest episodes I did, right up till this point, was the first set of... That was close. It's the first set of recordings I'd done with my new PC. And I'd actually left OBS to be recording at 15 megabyte bitrate, which is the YouTube recommended upload bitrate. And of course, previously I'd been using OBS, uploading the raw footage straight to YouTube. But now we're editing things because we've got a snazzy new intro, which I'm really pleased people seem to be liking. And, you know, I'm doing some editing here and there, time lapses, cuts, stuff like that. So yeah, having it on 15 megabytes bitrate recording and then rendering it at 15 megabytes bitrate didn't result in great quality. I mean, it still looks okay, but it looks a little washed out, a little blurry, a bit pixelated in parts, and I'm sure we can get it better. So I've actually massively increased my recording bitrate. Still going at 60 frames per second, obviously. But yeah, massively increased my recording bitrate. And I'm hoping, that it comes through in the quality. Let me know what you think in the comments anyway, if this has been better than previous episodes. I think with a game like this, where there is just so much undergrowth and stuff like that going on screen, it's kind of hard to achieve a constant quality without it looking a bit, you know, a bit pixelated. But short of, you know, reducing a load of settings, I don't want to do that. I mean, I've got most things on the maximum. Shadows I've got off. Well, you can see my settings right there. I don't want to reduce my quality, you know? I've just got this awesome new PC. I want to play everything maxed out. I want the best quality footage I can get. Anyway, enough about that. I mean, I suppose I could go back to using fraps. I used to use fraps to record all my stuff. And that gives you lossless files. Really big quality, really good quality, really huge file sizes though. Like ridiculously huge file sizes. And you need a really good, well, you don't need a really good, you need a fast hard drive to record to, and preferably not the same hard drive that you are running your games from. At least that's what I found in the past. Which isn't a problem. I have that set up, and I have my main system running on an SSD drive, and then I have a 2 terabyte drive, a SATA drive, just a regular SATA drive that I record to, and I have a separate 1 terabyte SATA drive that I have all my games on. So, you know, using fraps, it's not a big deal, but it's a bit of a resource hog when it comes to recording games. And the problem with it is, so you set your recording to be 60 frames per second, and if for any reason your game drops to below 60 frames per second, it will cap at 30. It won't just like bounce back unless you stop recording and start again. Now, you know, I don't think that my game would drop below 60 frames per second because it's actually running, you know, really well currently, but you know, I want to avoid that kind of I want to avoid those issues if I can. I'm out of the good things for I'm just gonna have to go a little further. So at some point, we are going to head into the caves, I think, because we can get a good axe in there, Can also get a katana. So, yeah, I'd like to go in there at some point and have a little explore. Previously, when I've gone into the caves, it's only because I've been captured. I can't believe how many... I need 49 sticks still. I can gather 10 at a time. So, yeah, we've got 5 more trips to do this. But anyway, yeah, we'll be going into the caves. Let me know what you think about that. Do you want to see me go into the caves? Maybe you do, maybe you don't. So, thing is with this game, you have two lives, essentially. The first time you die, you get dragged down into the caves. And you've got to try and escape. And the second time, you just die. So, this may be the one time that I may approve of save scumming. Because I want the series to go for a while. And I don't want to lose all my progress just to something stupid. I think it depends on what happens. But let me know what you think in the comments. Would you mind if I was to, you know, something stupid. If I did something daft and it cost me a life, would you be opposed to me reloading a save? I don't know. I don't like doing that. I'm very much against doing that kind of thing, to be quite honest. Let's come inside here. Okay, and we'll reset all of these. I mean, maybe I would let the first death go as normal without a restart, without a reload. But then, I don't know, maybe I would consider, you know, having a reload. I don't know, I don't even like talking about it. Honestly, I don't. I hate the idea of save scumming in a game like this. This game is a survival game, and it's meant to have permadeath. But, maybe I'm worrying unduly. I mean, I'm thinking like, oh my word, I might die in the next 2 episodes and then have to restart and we'd have to go through all this again and I'd have to do all the grinding again and all that gubbins. But, you know, maybe we'll be okay. We seem to be doing alright against the mutants, I'll be honest. I don't find them as much of a threat as they used to be. No, sorry, the cannibals, the mutants, we haven't actually faced yet. The mutants are a different story altogether. And they're a lot tougher. Oh, I already have 10. That was a waste. Yeah, the mutants are a different story altogether. I was just trying to think if I'd said the right word then, but I did. Although, it seems to be a running joke that people think I'm saying mutons. Mutons. So we've got to worry about muton attacks. You've got one that has like multiple arms, you've got a weird one that's all legs and kicks babies out that are all deformed, and then like a big bull charging type one, and they're going to take more punishment, which is why I'm sort of trying to stockpile. What was that? Oh, booze and coins. Okay, that's why I've been trying to stockpile explosives a bit, because, you know, when we get attacked by those things, I am going to let the bombs fly. You can be sure of that. So yeah, we haven't faced any mutons yet, but it's probably not going to be too long before we do. We're almost done with this. We're almost done. Wow. Okay. That actually went quicker than I was thinking. It would. I don't want these piddly one-stick bushes. It's a thing. A waste of my time. Anyway, hopefully we'll have some defensive walls up. Okay, before. Hopefully we'll have some defensive walls up before we have to face the mutons. These things aren't going to work against mutants. Now I've said it, I'm obsessed with saying it, so yeah, get ready for that. And they will attack our structures, so walls and stuff like that. Now we can build like spike wall sections on our walls, which I will do. Can't carry any more sticks. Oh, and we've got enough. Anyway, 7 of 7. That's all we needed. Awesome. Okay. We are done. Can I actually get in here without dying? No! No, I can't. Okay, that's fine. I'm gonna go and reset all these traps. So something else I want to make as well is a bow and arrow. And also I want... Okay, that's not what I want. I want this. So I'm going to build a fire pit. And I'm going to build it... Whatever, it doesn't matter. I'm going to build it right here. And I'm pressing the wrong button again. I want a bone holder. Bone basket. There we go. So I'll put the bone basket. Whatever. Doesn't matter. I'll put the bone basket right here. I need 25 sticks for this as well, so let's... Should have gone out the other way. Whatever, I can reset that. I can reset that at my own leisure. Wow, no sticks at all from that. How many do I need? 26. Okay. And I need some rocks as well, so we've got those. So I didn't know whether to montage this up, not montage, speed this process up, but yeah, I figured we'd just have a bit of a chat while I built. It's not always going to be like this. Sometimes I'm going to do stuff off camera, grinding for materials like I did before this episode. Sometimes we're just going to speed it up. Hopefully you don't mind this new format. Previously... Well, I say previously, in Project Zomboid, I like to record everything. Everything I do gets recorded. My dog is on the move. Everything I do gets recorded in Project Zomboid because it's so easy to die in that game. But I'm thinking it's maybe not the way to go for a game like this. And also Ark as well, which we're playing. Going out this way. Yeah, it's maybe not the way to go for this and Ark. Let me know what you think anyway. But I have a feeling most people are going to be perfectly fine with it. I'm showing enough of the building that it's not like, you know, every episode there's like 3 episodes worth of stuff built. You see my thought process while I'm going through it. So hopefully you're cool with this. We've actually gone a full episode without being attacked. It's amazing. Of course, now that I've said that, we're going to get attacked. I'm just hoping I can finish off what I wanted to get done today. Ton of sticks, I can't hold anymore. Yeah, I also want to... Whoa! Really, I'm that low on energy. Crouch down. I'm going to get rid of some of these stumps as well. I figure these platforms will be good for sniping enemies as well. Okay, almost done. Ominous thunder and lightning and rain. Well, that's good because at least my rain collector will get some stuff. I wonder if I can skip the night already. Actually, it's probably not dark enough to do that yet. You know what though? Let's just try something out here. Color grading. M131. That's actually not bad, is it? Oh, it's nice to know then that I don't always have to remember to deal with the brightness settings. Oh, that's so good. Okay. Alright, well now we have an answer to the nighttime. I hope this is bright enough. Let me know in the comments again what you think. Is this workable? What do we do? Do we skip nights? Do we work through the nights? Do I need to edit them? You know, add a brightness filter in the edit? I don't know. Maybe this will do. Maybe this is good enough. It certainly seems a lot better than, you know, the regular lighting. Well, not during the day, but yeah. Alright, so that is our trap area done. Oh, hello. Well, we get to test it out, guys. Come get some. Come on, come get some. Uh-oh, they're in. One of them's in anyway. Two of them are in. Yeah, come get some. Oh, this is good. I like this. I mean, alright, occasionally, yeah, some of them will get through. But for the most part, this works pretty well. So yeah, this, I got this idea from watching Cage848's videos. He calls this the Bone Zone. I think I'm going to call it the Cage. In honor of the guy I got the idea from. I've mentioned him a lot lately, but you should check him out. The guy does really good survival videos. He really does. That didn't light at all, liar. There we go. So now we just take the bodies, we dump them on here. Boom. We'll wait for those to burn up. And then we collect the bones, store them in the basket, and now we have a nice little place to come when we are being attacked. We'll also be coming out here and checking on it every now and again, because you brought your buddies, did you? Good luck. Yeah. They don't like it. That's what you get for messing with me. That is what you get for messing with me. Wow. This thing is crazy. Stop going off for a second. There we go. I'm going to have this video run a little bit longer while we deal with these morons who, you know, how many times do you need to see their friends die like that before they get the message? Yeah. These things going off, it reminds me of that Simpsons episode where Sideshow Bob keeps stepping on the rakes. You know what I mean? I love it. Oh, it's so good. Yeah, so I was going to end the episode, but I think we're going to wait for this attack to finish. Burn, baby, burn. Hello, you got through, but now you are back. That's fine. So I've just got to keep resetting these traps. Watching these morons run into them. And there we go. Two more down. That's kind of... Uh-oh. Okay, wasn't expecting that. This guy was faking me out. Clever boy. He faked me out. Acting like he'd been caught in the trap. He wasn't caught in the trap. He's just going to stand there like a moron. Fine. Dump you on there. Drop these off. Really? Fine. Okay, well, let's just go and take care of this one old school. I'm going to axe him in the face. I'm going to axe him a question. He's actually stuck on all this garbage anyway, so... Okay, he's invincible now. What's that about? Oh my word. And another one. Alright, I should have ended this episode after all. Maybe not. Maybe we're gonna run a little bit longer. Come on, I just want to climb up here and finish up. Thank you. Moron, you should have taken your chance while you had it. Alright, well, I guess I'm tempted to just end the episode here then, after all. I wonder if it's the fire that's attracting them. I bet it is. I bet it's the fire that's attracting them. So we want... We won't start the fire off again. Wow, I am just rocking tons of bones here. So I'm just going to dump this body right here. I hope on a reload, that guy will just go away on his own. Yeah, I think maybe the fire's attracted them. Got any more? No. Maybe if I should just burn these two up as well. May as well do, right? Okay, well, I guess that is going to do us for today then, guys. As always, I really hope you've enjoyed watching this. Let me know in the comments what you think to our little kill area here. But yeah, that's the end of the episode. I'm out for now, and I will see you soon for some more of The Forest. Peace.